Testing? That was weird. Huh. All of my audio settings are off. Hold on a second. I don't know why. That's probably what's been breaking. Okay, so over the last few days, anytime my computer goes into sleep mode, it's not been able to find my devices. It's been like on bloop, 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 bloop. I'm guessing it's my audio deck. So, as I was saying before, my mic wasn't working. This is a beat up box. This box is beat to all hell. Yeah, like for some weird reason, a lot of my settings are getting reset. And like I'll let my computer, you know, just go to sleep mode. And I'll walk out and I'll come back to the room. It'll be in sleep mode and I'll hear boop boom, boop boom, boop boom, boop boom. And something is just plugging in and unplugging it, and it doesn't pop up on my USB program. So what is the theme? Let's see if everything's here first. So let me guess the theme. We have from the world of Nintendo, a Metroid. There's also an orange squid, white Tanuki Mario, Tom Nook, Ice Mario, Red Yoshi, Fire Luigi, and Bob Bomb. So I got a Metroid. It seems we got an Overwatch t-shirt. Oh, Overwatch Anniversary t-shirt. Something from Destiny. Oh, hold. This might be cool. A Deva would... I might actually make this. If someone wants to watch me make that pin. So let's see what the theme is. So it's... The poster is clearly what's on the shirt. Just basically... No. There we go. So, it's an anniversary. I might keep that. Oh, let's see. It is an Overwatch Deva model. The World Nintendo Metroid figure. The exclusive Overwatch Heroes t-shirt. The exclusive Destiny 2 Ghost keychain. Want your ghost to look at this in-game? The last city shell can be equipped by all class at level 10 and above. The exclusive Pew Pew pin. And an epic drop would receive an Overwatch Diva statue. Which would ironically go well with my Diva desk covering here. And I don't know why I have a Diva desk covering. By the way, I was at Fry's Electronics on Thursday. And I saw a Diva Razer headset. So it's her headset. Coyote was telling me to buy it. He just kept telling me to buy it. Just buy it. Just buy it. It was bright pink. Has the two little antennas, but I'm like, no man, no. I have the money, but goddamn no. So it's just a Blizzard theme. But it doesn't have a theme. It's like anniversary? The theme is Pew Pew. Okay. But if we go here, we got Blizzard Activision, Nintendo. Generic. So, it's one of those things again. But the poster's not too bad. The posters are actually okay. I actually have a few of these posters. I'm actually going to be rearranging this room, I'm thinking. Because I have a lot of things to do. Like, I might have mentioned this, where my complex made me change out my window covering, so now I put in pink XPF foam, painted white. But, I'm actually going to rearrange all this. This is all going to spin there. That's going to spin over here, and I'm going to move some of these posters around, but you'll have more poster viewing when I get that done. Do that next weekend, maybe next week, 2 weeks from now. I plan on doing all that. I plan on getting back into streaming now that I'm on a set schedule. My body is actually recovering. Let's take a look at this, though. Let's take a look at this Metroid. Since I do not care about mint thin box. It's squishy. Where'd it go? Did it go in my shoes? No. No. Behind my surround sound system. So it's a... It's squishy. It's squishy. So... It's actually clearer on the camera than it is in real life. So... Oh, it's actually meant to be squished. It's got the little pressure hole. Okay, cool. Let's see what this thing's about. Got an instruction manual. That's how I do these videos. I just throw things randomly. I like that. I like that concept. Give Schrodinger something to play with. Non-rechargeable batteries are not to be recharged. Rechargeable batteries are to be removed from product before being charged. How would you charge a battery? Never mind. Different types of batteries should there be used. If this thing only holds one battery, then does it hold multiple batteries? It only holds one battery. No, wait, it holds three DCs. Oh no, I don't like AG3s. They're fucking crap. You gotta be kidding me. Those things are crap. Okay. That's as far as we read. Pull. It's all it does. That's pretty much what it does. I was expecting something more. Yeah, I was expecting a little more. And then lastly, we have this. An Incredibuild collectible wood art. What type of glue do they say I should use? Let's see. Do they want me to use wood glue? Or do they want me to use PCA or PVC? Because I have pretty much all this in the room right there. Wow, the building instructions. Go through the instructions. Wow. Plan, technique, process. If someone really... Steps 1 through 42. Steps 43 through 107. Well, it comes with a poster. So I guess I can just become a... Just make Dave on my waifu, I guess, at this rate. You know. Not by choice. The universe picked this for me. I did not pick this. Wait, are they... Ooh, no. I'm guessing... They're not laser cut. Ooh, that's not good. If they're not properly laser cut, then you have to cut them out yourself. And, I have the tools, most people wouldn't. And if they're not properly laser cut. Okay, well, they are. They are properly laser cut. Okay. They're just really tightly laser cut. Okay. Yeah, I actually have all the tools for this. Because I got into model building. Well, miniatures. I'm actually trying to paint some miniatures on the side. That was today's goal. But yeah, I could set up the camera and stuff in the other room if anyone wanted to watch this. Make it your own. But, Wait. Before you start building and decorating your model, make a plan. Do you want to make an exact replica of the project below or create something of your own design? Anything goes. I don't think you really can make something of your own design. As for the light pink, I would probably go with my own colors. I'd probably give her a custom color scheme. Because I don't have pink. I mean, I have red. I'd give it a metallic. I have a lot of metallics. I could probably mix metallic acrylic paint. Well, this good with acrylic. I have lots of good stuff. I have miniature paints, too. Some really expensive miniature paint. I wouldn't use that. But I could give this some. I have some really nice miniature brushes, too. But do they want you to paint it before assembly or after assembly? See, the problem is knowing exactly what piece is what before you can paint it. Let's see. Before assembling, pylon thicknesses and colors may vary. Well, not necessarily glue, maybe applied if there's also glue only. Okay. Well, I would use wire down PVA glue, which I have. I have lots of Elmer's glue. I also have tacky glue, too. I can also use Mod Podge, too, and give it a gloss afterwards. I have some gloss Mod Podge. Tweezer toothpick. I have plenty of X-Acto knives and helping hands. Yeah, I know. If this is something where someone wants to watch, I'll dedicate today to playing with this instead. I'll set up an entire camera system if someone wants to watch this. But I'd have to go set it up, and I have to get my laptop working, set up my streaming information. But yeah, insert piece 91 at the very bottom of the piece 90. Okay. That is going to be fun. Push piece 112 straight back and then push down so it attaches to the notch below piece 109. Whew. Basically, they make you make two sections. They make you make the top half and then eventually make the bottom half and then cut the two. Literally, that's what they want you to do. But. Well, anyway, I have this. I'll put this to the side. They also came with this. It's Incredibuilds. This is actually probably one of the better loot crates, at least items in a loot crate that I've seen. It's unique. But they have like R2-D2. Oh, look, there's a Dobby. It's a Dobby. You can barely see that because of a Millennium Falcon. Oh, Assassin's Creed. Sweet. And it extends. That's cool. I like that. Destiny. What else they got? Buckbeak, Batmobile, Dory, X-Wing, TIE Fighter, Millennium Falcon. You know. Oh, got some more in the back. Generic animals. But, yeah. Honestly, out of this is actually not the worst. Being honest, I've seen a worse build. I don't get for the theme, it's a bit questioning. It's like, okay, you know, pew pew, with just the character, but the wood building, I don't get why they went with a wood building kit. Also, you can't really tell, but if you notice, you see that glare right there? Right there. That's a second sticker. This used to be... includes step-by-step laser-cut wood piece, step-by-step coloring, and I'm gonna pull this off. Okay, and it says on here, okay, if you could see that, I don't know if you could see that through that, let's see, focus, there we go, poster, a diva poster, right? What it used to be, because it got covered up, is a Captain America booklet. Yes, the Overwatch Diva's Mecha used to be bundled with a Captain America book. Huh. I don't know if Disney would really agree with this, but okay. This is also a 4-star difficulty. Probably not the one thing you should be giving out, Loot Crate. So I believe these range from 1 to 5. I've actually been thinking about getting into some of these. Yeah, no, that's basically what that was saying. Was, if you go by this, it was signed off that Disney and Overwatch were basically going to work together. Or they bundled an Captain America booklet, but then they covered it with a sticker after the fact, thinking no one would remove the sticker, you know. Whoops. Now they thought no one would remove this sticker, like me. The most cynical person probably on the planet right now. Because that's what it used to be before I ripped it. A Diva poster. Hmm. It's funny, it even says, and poster at the top, somewhere over here. And on the back, it... doesn't say anything about... yeah, it says nothing... that's a massive typo. It is a massive typo because on the back, I'm just scanning through it. Because on the back it says Loot Crate, you know. 2018 Loot Crate logo is registered Loot Crate. So this is commissioned by Loot Crate. Licensed Blizzard product. All the copyright information is to Blizzard. Inside Editions, who makes this. A division of Incredibuild, a division of Inside Editions. All rights reserved. Manufactured in China. So basically, for whatever reason, when they made this box, they misprinted it that badly. Also... I don't know, I guess now I'm being cynical. Like, I'm trying to find other mistakes now. Like, because if there's one mistake, there's got to be something they missed. Oh, there's got to be something. Oh, this is just me having fun now. I love these kind of things. I love these mistakes. I love mistakes like this. But yeah. So there's that. So we got that. We got a t-shirt, you know, anniversary edition t-shirt. I'm not sure I sold the back. It's just that. And it's, let's see. What can I see? It's, it's not silk screen. Wait. It's not gonna it's gonna fade. It's gonna fade pretty fast. In fact, I can already see color flaws. Like, right... I don't know if you can see this. But, on Hanzo's face, he's got a red nose. There's a red dot on his chest. And his face. So there's already... Now I'm being really critical. I'm also trying to find pixelation, quality, you know, like mistakes. It's a shirt. It's a t-shirt. It's a t-shirt. It's a medium t-shirt. Large. Sorry, it's a large. I guess I got a large. It's a large t-shirt. A cotton t-shirt. I guess this is the military part of me, but, like, I actually do inspect, I do actually inspect any, if I get a t-shirt, like, you know, I pay for a t-shirt, I actually do inspect the stitching, just how I am. I've never done it on here, because I really don't care much, but I try to inspect the stitching, because a lot of times, stitching is actually done wrong. And actually, in this case, it is done wrong. Wait. Yeah, so this one sleeve here is actually going to rip first. It's going to rip right here because they overstitched. And they bunched it. Bunched it up. I go through a lot of shirts, actually. That's why I only wear black. In fact, most of my Loot Crate shirts have gotten destroyed. But yeah, so I got that. It's a nice shirt. I'd wear it. Then again, I wear this one. This is a fucking show I don't even like. Spoilers, I don't like Walking Dead. I cannot accept a universe in which zombie movies never existed. Or any undead movies never existed. I can't. I can't accept it. That's what it is. That's the whole Walking Dead spoiler. It's about a universe that doesn't have fucking any zombie movies. So. Got a little guy. Got a useless sound maker. And a t-shirt. And the only cool thing is this, and this thing supposedly is a finished model of 5 inches, so about that tall, so it's about that big, it's the size of a glass, this glass. Maybe a little, this is about 6 inch tall glass. So probably about that big. Not bad. Yes, that's the exact plot element. That's why they call them walkers. Well, you know, if you didn't know this, for Walking Dead, the entire plot hook, the reason why they don't know how to fight the zombies is because they're in a universe that has never had a zombie movie, ever. So they don't know to shoot the head, or to smash the brain, or that they're dead. They're called walkers because that's the name they give, or biters, that's the name they gave in the universe. They never say zombie, because there is no zombies. That is the plot hook of The Walking Dead. Done. That's why I don't like it. Stupid. Oh, that and It's inconsistent. Gunfire is bad. You're supposed to wear earmuffs. Cops are taught, you know, don't fire the gun unless you have to, when you're in shooting range. So early on, when the first episode in the first season, he has to shoot a gun, and he's, like, under a car, and it's like the bing! So, you know, he gets deafened. Then they take that plot and says, oh, guns can make you go deaf, and then throw it out, and then allow the characters to just shoot guns and have no effect. But then later on, they're walking through a forest. Zombies don't walk very fast. They get surprised by a zombie. Because secretly they're all deaf. By the end of life, season 4 or 5, they can't hear. They're all fucking just down. This doesn't work. This no longer works. But yeah, no. The Walking Dead is a very cut and paste. They took things. It's weird. Yeah, if you actually know firearms, The Walking Dead brings up a lot of weird questions. First off, the Zombie Survival Guide, if you haven't read it, great book, starts that, one, don't use sharp weapons. Don't. Sharp weapons tend to get lodged in the thing they're hitting. Unless you're using something specialized, like some Japanese swords, or some, pretty much Japanese swords, and it's constantly upkept, you're gonna get your weapon lodged in your target. You go blunt weapons, which is what this character, Negan, whatever the fuck it is, he's actually correct. He uses a baseball bat.
Hey, don't.
That's correct. You use blunt weapons. 2, don't use firearms. 3, don't travel by car. 4, travel by bike. You want to stay mobile, low profile. 3, oh, lastly, you want to travel during the initial outbreak to the desert. And then after the initial outbreak, within 1 year of the outbreak, if this was real life, actually within 5 months of an outbreak, you then want to go to a colder zone. Because here's why. A dead body is just a dead body. A zombie is a dead body. Zombies rot. Heat makes things rot. You go to a desert, you'll survive the initial. Anything that doesn't die doesn't decay fast within the first 3 months, because in your zone, 3 months, you'll have no more fresh zombies, unless no one gets reinfected. So, 3 months, no more fresh zombies. The next 3 months is for you to gather up and then move to cold climate, where zombies could in fact still be, but the initial outbreak 6 months later, they should all be decayed. That's why you go there. That's why you do that exact thing. Unless, of course, it's summertime. If it's summer, you may not want to go to the desert, but to a plains because of heat. Unless water and power systems are still working. If water and power still work, which anywhere next to a major dam, like the Hoover Dam, that power system should still stay in effect. The Hoover Dam is not going to stop. It's going to continue to produce power. The problem is, if it produces power, those poles could go down. You want to be close to that location. But dude, zombie survival inside here. I have thought of these things. Coyote thinks I'm crazy that I have a survival plan for everything. If an issue were to come out, I have 2 bathrooms set up to fill up with water, and I have plastic to drape over it. I was already in the process of getting a 30-day food supply just put away. But of course, zombieism, as we know it, as the media, as the TV shows have done it, is dead body reanimated. Dead body reanimated doesn't get oxygen. Oxygen doesn't go into the muscles. Muscles then produce, the use of muscles without oxygen produces an acid, which the body isn't removing. The acid eats the muscles, decaying the muscles, thus making your super zombies, the ones who would run really fast, the ones who would die the fastest. But besides the point. So I got some fun things. But yeah, that's my entire unboxing. It was a tiny thing. This is literally the entire box. And all I have else is four copies of right there of Red Dragon Inn, in case anyone. Nobody lives in the area, so nobody's really gonna come over and play. But parasites. There is a known parasite currently that is infecting rats. And this parasite causes the rats to become very brave, and the rat will actually challenge feral cats. And in the hopes that the feral cat will eat it. This is actually something they have discovered. What the parasite's doing after that, it's not really known. It's not infecting the cat. And I'm not sure if it's using it to, yeah, once getting the cat system. But it's not infecting the cat. Is it getting through the cat through poop? Because there is the one that affects ants and snails. It gets into the bird, and then the bird incubates it in its stomach and then poops it out. But the bird's fine. But that is how that parasite makes the jump from rat to cat to human. We get zombies. But yeah, I got nothing more. But if anyone wants to, if you want to see me build that on stream, I'll set up something. I have a Yeah. I have plenty of cameras. I could put this camera on a tripod. I have plenty of tripods. I have lights, studio lights. I could set up something really fast. I don't know if that laptop could even run that. Ooh, that's a good point. I have my Blue Yeti. Yeah, I could do something, but that's if somebody wants that. If so, Discord's up there. You can pester me. Yeah, but I'm gonna go ahead and cut this. I'm going to go cut myself some more on models. I'm preparing some models. I got a new board game. I'll send pictures if someone wants to see it. But I have to build the models and paint them. And I'm not even sure what I'm going to do with them. But yeah. Yeah. I don't have Death Watch. I got a text message. Yay! Who's it from? Coyote? Yep, it is. Sweet. Anyways.